The water has mixed inside this fridge compressor. Can we filter the water out from this fridge compressor? This is what we will see in this video. I have removed the compressor out from the refrigerator. It has water. Inside mix with oil. Let's try to clean and flush the water out from the compressor. For making the water out of the compressor, I welded the pipe with the charging line, which was damaged. Now I will make the water out from its suction line. Oh no! The compressor is full of water which has been mixed with compressor oil. It's full of water I am showing you. Is the compressor okay? Now I have attached the nitrogen cylinder with the compressor. Now I will give the pressure of the nitrogen to the compressor so it can get dry. The owner who brought this fridge to me for repair. They, on the spot, switched off the refrigerator when the evaporator of the fridge was hit with a knife. The water, when melted, then it went down inside the compressor. Let me put the nitrogen pressure inside the compressor and see what happens. Now I have opened the nitrogen cylinder, and this pressure is ideal for this situation. When I gave nitrogen pressure to the compressor, I noticed one thing. The camera was far away, so let me show you by zooming in on the camera. The water started to come out of the discharge pipe as well, which is not a good indication for the compressor. So let's see what happens next. Now the compressor is better than before and has dried out. As you saw, I passed nitrogen gas pressure inside the compressor, which should have been clean and dried out because it was invisible to me as I could not see inside the compressor. Now I will fill the compressor with oil again. I will indicate through the oil whether the compressor has any water left inside it or not. This is a 1x5 size compressor. The capacity of oil charged in this compressor size is 180 milliliter. As I could not run the compressor, I am using a syringe to fill the compressor with oil. I have filled the compressor with oil. Next, I will turn the compressor upside down, so that the oil could touch the part and get out of the compressor quickly. This way, the water inside the compressor will come out. See, the water has come out of the compressor. I can see the water spots inside the bowl. The water came out of the compressor mixed with oil. This means the water is still present inside the compressor. I will pour more oil inside the compressor to clean it. When I made the oil out of the compressor, I filled it inside. And see, the water is still mixed with the compressor oil. Let's pour another oil inside the compressor, and then I will start the compressor and see how it works. As I have cleaned this compressor with nitrogen, let's test it with the multimeter. After testing it, then I will give it a start. So let's check whether it passes the multimeter test or not. So I have attached one probe of the multimeter with the compressor or any terminal. And let's test its body short first. It has a resistance value of 7.4 mega ohms, which means it is body shorted. As it is showing body short, we could not attach this compressor to the refrigerator. Now I have cut the compressor. Would it be useful if we cleaned it with oil and installed it in the compressor? See, when I open its head cover from the top. See, it has an awful situation from the inside. It has completely rusted. The piston and the rotor of this compressor have jammed. The winding is also showing short with the body. Again, it could be due to the water. But I will not take any chance. If I work further on this compressor, I will also waste time and money. The best option for me is to install a new compressor, and all the problems will be fixed. This is for today's video. I will see you at the next one. So watch the next video by clicking on the left or right thumbnail on the screen if you are interested. And subscribe. It is free. Thank you.